until chapter 5 verse 11. So siguro tayo po lahat ay tumayo, basahin na lang po. May I request the congregation to read 1 Thessalonians chapter 4 verse 13 until 18. Okay, if you are there, may I request the congregation to read these verses. Ready? Read. Pray. Our glorious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this morning. Lord, we just want to continue to thank you, God, for your faithfulness in our life. We thank you, Lord, for thy words that we have read, that we'll be having this morning. We thank you, God, for your love to us. We thank you because we always have a blessed hope in our life. We thank you, God, and we ask you right now, God, to move upon our midst, Lord. Let your message be made known to thy people, O God. Holy Spirit, be the one to move in our hearts. Illuminate our hearts. Illuminate our minds. Continue to encourage us. Continue to rebuke us. Continue to strengthen us through thy words, O God. Lord, as your servant, I cannot do anything, O God, apart from you. I just ask strength, wisdom, your anointing, O God, as I preach your word, O God. Lord, please help me. I cannot do anything apart from you. I just pray this morning, may we glorify your name and may we be blessed through thy words, O God. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Okay, so this morning, I think you have an idea what will be the topic this morning. So, when you read the verses, I know that it is about the coming of the Lord. Amen. My question is this. So when we read the Word of God, are we excited when we see that the Lord is coming? Are you excited? Are you, sabi nga rito, are you enjoying His coming? Or let me say it this way. Are you excited for His coming? The title of my preaching this morning is His Coming is My Rejoicing in Living. Okay? His coming is my rejoicing in living. To be honest with you, my brother and my sister, I just want to ask you this question. Do we know these verses from the Bible that the Lord is coming? And we may be experiencing a lot of troubles, difficulties in life, but we have hope. And that is the promise of God. No matter big problems we have, the Lord will still come. Whether the unbelievers will believe, will not believe, the Lord will still come. Amen. But for us, mamaya po, makikita ninyo yung side po natin as a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ that we have a blessed hope. We have a Christ. So, in this sermon, in this preaching, we are going to see the difference between the unbelievers and we will see the difference of our difference to them. We should be knowledgeable about this. The Bible says, come out from among them and be ye separate. There is separation between the righteous and the unrighteous. We should know that. Dapat makita po natin that we, the people of God, should be the one rejoicing for His coming. But the problem is this. Baka nga po hindi natin alam yung doktrina na to eh. By the way, IBCSR, we believe in pre-tribulation doctrine. We believe that it will rapture first, the tribulation, and then the millennium. Yun pong paniniwala natin. We don't just believe in this because a lot of people believe in this. But we believe on this because that is what the Bible says. That is what the scripture says. So dapat po malaman po natin yun. Dapat maging knowledgeable tayo pagdating dito. Huwag tayong maging ignorant. Di ba lagi sinasabi ni Paul, be ye not an ignorant. Alam mo yung ignorant? Walang alam. Pero sabi niya kayo, iba kayo. So I hope and I pray that you will be encouraged, you will be strengthened, you will be rebuked by the word of God this morning. So tayo po, I hope and I pray, alam niyo po ito. I believe you know the coming of the Lord. There are a lot of things that we can learn here. So here we can see that it is about the coming of the Lord. But on the other side, you are going to see ourselves, what we should do as a believer of the Lord Jesus Christ. First, it says here, okay, in verse 1 and 2 first, let's go in verse 1 and 2. Where's that? Okay, it says here, but of the times and the season, brethren, ye have no need that I write unto you. Verse 2, for yourselves know perfectly that the day of the Lord so cometh as a thief in the night. But look at the word here. Look at this word. For yourselves know perfectly. What did? That is what the Bible says. We cannot argue with that. The Bible says, we know perfectly. But, ano bang sinasabi rito? Eh, ang sabi po lang, if you will go, Brother Preacher John, please, in Mark 13, verse 32. Okay, does it contradict this verse? It says, but of that day and that hour knoweth no man, no not angels which are in heaven, neither the Son, but the Father, in 33. Take ye heed, watch and pray, for ye know not when the time is. Okay, it says here, not even the Son of God, not even Jesus Christ when he was here on earth, the coming is second coming. Even him, he said in a human form. He said even the Son of God do not know this. Even the angels do not know this. But if you are going to go in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 1, or in verse 2, it says here, for yourselves know perfectly. Alin perfectly na alam mo? Ito po yung sinasabi doon. What it means is that what we know perfectly, that he will be coming as a thief in the night. That we know he is coming. Yun pong sinasabing perfectly doon. That we know that the Lord will come again as a thief. Pero hindi natin alam yun. Believers and unbelievers, they have something in common. What's that? They do not know the time. No one knows the time. But, it says in verse 2, ye know perfectly. Ang ibig sabihin, alam nyo na yung darating ang Panginoon, kagaya ng isang magnanakaw. If you will go to a... Okay, let me give you some verses first. In Matthew 24, verse 43, Brother John. Matthew 24:43. It says here, but know this, that if the kingdom of the house had known in what watch the thief would come, he would have watched and would not have suffered his house to be broken up. Natural. Kung alam mo darating ng magnanakaw, hindi mo papayagan yun. Patay siya pag bumasok siya. 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 10. Okay, it says here, but the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in the which the heavens shall pass away with a great noise, and the elements shall melt with fervent heat. The earth also and the works that are therein shall be burned up. He will come as a thief in the night. Revelation chapter 3, verse 3. It says here, remember therefore how thou hast received and heard, and hold fast and repent. If therefore thou shalt not watch, I will come on thee as a thief, and thou shalt not know what hour I will come upon thee. So no one knows the coming of the Lord. But it says here in verse 2, we know perfectly. Okay? When we know, alam niyo po, we know perfectly that He will be coming. Ang pagkakaiba nito, ganito. This is the difference between us and the unbeliever. The unbeliever, they do not know. They don't even believe. Pero tayo, ang problema ito. We have a Christ coming. Are we celebrating? It doesn't mean we preach. It doesn't mean si pastor nagpipreach o mga deacons. We are also struggling like you. But the problem is this. Do you know the word of God? Are you rejoicing for the coming of the Lord? Are you excited for the coming of Christ? Christ will come. Doon tayo nakapokus. We are focusing on that day. But look at this. Let's go to verse number 3. It says in verse 4, look in verse 4 first. Should not overtake you. Let me, Brother John, please, in verse 4. In verse 4 it says, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. Okay. And if you will go, it means to say that something like this. Bago pa dumating ang magnanakaw, nandun ka na. And you are already prepared. Same thing with us. Bago dumating ang Panginoon, we are already prepared. That's what the Bible says. That's why the Bible says, be watchful. Be sober. Okay? Yun po tayo. But if you will go to verse number 3, let me go to the unbelievers first. Verse number 3. Okay, verse number 3, it says here, for when they shall say, peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them. To whom? The unbelievers. As travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. Okay. Okay. Let me just recap my outline first. Okay. It says here, in verse number 3, for a sudden destruction will come upon them, and as a travail upon a woman with a child. Yung mga babae dito, at least ako po may asawa na, meron akong asawa, meron na kaming isang anak. I know when my wife labored, nung po magbibigay na siya ng birth kay Aljon. And most of the mothers here, you know that. This is what the meaning of the as travail upon a woman with child. Kapag ang babae, medyo nagle-labor pa ng 2 cm, 3 cm, okay pa yan. They can still smile. 4 cm, 5 cm, nakaka-smile pa yan. 7, medyo tumitindi na. 8, tumitindi na. 9, 10, until pag manganganak na ang babae o yung woman when she will about to give birth, she cannot go anywhere. Have you noticed that? Natural ba ang anak? No. Look at the truth in this. Kapag manganganak na uwang sa babae, when a woman will give birth, she cannot even turn to the right or even turn to the left or even think of something, of anything but to give birth. What she need to do is to give way for the coming of the child. Amen. Same thing. When the Lord comes, the unbelievers will give way to the coming of the Lord, whether they like it or not. But there will be a sudden destruction that will happen to the unbelievers. The Bible says it is good for you not to be born on this world. Mabuti pa sa kanilang hindi na ipinanganak. When that time comes, they will give way to the coming of Christ. And here, and there will be, ang masakit dito, there will be no escape. They cannot escape anymore. Imagine this. You are walking or in a wilderness or in a forest or in a jungle. Imagining that you are walking, while walking, before you sense the danger, before you sense the danger, you are already inside the trap. Ganun kabilis yun. Before they will even know that the Lord comes, we are already there. And they were left behind. That will happen to the unbelievers. For us, yes, we are rejoicing for the coming of the Lord. Look what will happen. What if that is your father? What if that is your mother? What if that is your son or your daughter? What if those are your relatives? What will happen? Kapatid, this is not a joke. It is no joke. Christ will come and these people will be punished. Mapapanis po sila pag dumating ang Panginoon. Kapatid, that how serious this is. Ang akala po natin is something like, oh, the Lord will come. Or something that we can say na okay lang. But you know, this is no joke. This is no joke. The Lord will come. He will come. He said, I will come as a thief in the night. Darating ako ng parang isang mandaragit na hindi nyo alam. But on our side, this is the most glorious day that will happen to us. That's why I'm asking you, are you really excited for the coming of the Lord? Patid, wala na akong sasaya pa dito. Wala na akong sasaya pa dito. The coming of the Lord is something that we can say, not even the treasure of the whole universe, not the world, the whole universe can compare to that day. Nothing can be compared. It says here, but in verse 4, let us read verse 4. Verse 4 says, but ye brethren are not in darkness, that the day should overtake you as a thief. Okay, look at this. Look at the word but. B-U-T. See the difference now? Now you will see the difference between the unbelievers and the believers. It says here, but ye brethren are not in darkness. In Colossians chapter 1, verse 13. Colossians 1, 13. It says here, who hath delivered us from the power of darkness and hath translated us into the kingdom of his dear Son. What does it mean? We were transferred from darkness unto light. The Son of God is the light. But before, we are darkness. We are darkness. I want you to see that. Para wala ho tayong pagmamalaki. You will see the difference before now and then. And you will now see your life if you are really a different person. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Misan inaanyo si Brother Jong, 2 Corinthians 5:17. Well, after you got saved, that is one of the most important verse in your life. 2 Corinthians 5:17. Perfecto ba kami? No. Dami nga naming mali. But that is what the Word of God says. That is what the Word of God says. It says here, you were darkness. Okay. It says before, if I'm not mistaken, in Genesis chapter 1 verse 3, the Lord said, let there be light. And there was. When we came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, we are in darkness, the darkness of sin. We were filthy. We are so disgusting before God because of sin. But when we accepted Christ in our life, the Lord says, let there be light. And we were enlightened by the Word of God. Okay, so it's difficult for us, a person who says, I am a Christian, that there is no change. Difficult. Sabi ko sa inyo, when you became a Christian, it is difficult for you not to be changed life. But the Bible says, that time, the Lord says, when you accepted the Lord Jesus Christ, let there be light. Let there be light in Mili. Let there be light in Army. Let there be light in you. Dumating ang Panginoon sa buhay natin. Parang mas maganda pa yung parang greater power pa ito dun pa nung sinabi ng Lord when He created the universe or the world. It is greater than that. Because of us, tayo po ay mismong makasalanan. You know what it took for that light to sink into us? The Son of God must die on the cross. That is the only way for that light to sink into our lives. Christ must die for you and for me. Christ must die. Imagine that. The Son of God died. And you know, if you will go to Isaiah 53 verse 10, if I'm not mistaken, and the Father was pleased to crush His Son because of our sin. Yun po ang dapat makita natin, na hindi lang ganun kadali nung namatay si Kristo sa krus. When Christ died on the cross, He was crushed by the Father because of your sin, because of my sin. That's what happened. That's why here, it says here, we are not in darkness, or we were darkness before, but now we were enlightened by the Word of God. We were enlightened because Christ is in us. It means to say that now we are different. 2 Corinthians 5:17. If anyone be in Christ, is a new creature. The whole thing has passed away. Behold, the new has come. Teka mo nga, baka NIV yung nasabi ko, sir. Yan mo nga. Therefore, if anyone be in Christ, he is a new creature. The old thing has passed away. Behold, all things are become new. Ano pong ibig sabihin ng verse nito? We are now different. We are not the same anymore. We are not the same anymore. Oo, marami po tayong struggle. Marami po tayong nagagawang pagkakamali. Ang sabi nga lang ni Preacher Gomez, we commit mistakes, but we don't do mistakes. I will give you the difference. Para pong ito, let me use this illustration, yung pong narinig ko lang to. Narinig ko lang naman to. Meron daw isang businessman, he always go to work around 7 in the morning. He will go to work, and he must leave home at least 7. Okay, what he do is like this. Nung 7 na, nagmamadali na siya. At sa pagmamadali niya, nasipa niya yung trash can o yung bin. Then lumabas siya, inampas yung pinto, sumasa ka kotse. At sabi ng asawa niya, wait, wala akong pakiraso. Alis na ako, pumunta akong trabaho. Okay, kasi hindi pa sa Christian eh. He is not yet enlightened. He is not yet a new creature. Pero nung siya maging new creature na, ganito nangyari. Same thing. 7 o'clock, he must be in the office. But the problem, nagmamadali siya, nasipa niya yung bin, sinabi ng asawa niya, teka sandali, wala akong pakialam, alis na ako. He slammed the door, go inside the car, and then he stopped. What is the difference? Anong pagkakaiba nung 2 Corinthians 5:17? Ito po. When he accepted the Lord Jesus Christ in his life, when he truly accepted the Lord in his heart, when he does that the second time, when he was already a believer, he stopped for a while, he sensed his mistake, he asked for forgiveness from God, and he went back to his home, asked forgiveness to his wife, and called the boss, please, I will be late for 5 minutes. But what I'm trying to say, there is repentance. There is a change of heart when we know the Lord. When we came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, there is a change in our life, whether we like it or not. Sabi ko nga sa inyo, it's hard to not to change when you have Christ in your life. It is really hard. Alam niyo po ako, when I came to know the Lord, dati po akong naninigarilyo. When I came to know Him, all of a sudden my smoking stopped, my drinking stopped. But after a week, I tried to smoke. But when I smoke again, the taste of the cigarette is like hell. But you know, no, talagang iba na yung lasa. Hindi ko na matanggap. And I said, this is the change of God in my life. There will be change. Hindi lang ako. Maging kayo. Okay. In Romans chapter 13, verse 12, it says, the night is far spent, the day is at hand. Let us therefore cast off the works of darkness, and let us put on the armor of light. See? Cast off. Itapon mo na yan. Yung gawa ng kadiliman sa buhay mo. Hindi po tayo perfecto, but we don't do sin in our life. We commit mistakes. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 8. It says here, for ye were sometimes darkness. Kayo'y dating kadiliman. But now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as a children of light. Whether you like it or not, you are now a child of light. You are now a child of God. In 1 John 2:8, it says here, again, a new commandment I write unto you, which thing is true in him and in you, because the darkness is past, and the true light now shineth. See? When we now have Christ, we shine. We shine, whether you like it or not. Kapatid, alam niyo po, marami po tayong problema ang dinaranas. Sino ba mag-aakalang may mga problema? Huwag niyo sabihin dito, lahat tayo may problema. Pag wala kang problema, patay ka na. That is the truth of that. Pero kapatid, this is what the Word of God says. And the true light, who's the truth? Jesus said, I am the truth. Now, light shineth upon us. Light shineth upon us. Christ is in us now. He is now shining in our life. It says in Matthew 5:16, let your light so shine before men that they may glorify your Father which is in heaven. Let your light so shine. Pati, ano yung shine na yun? Yung light na yun, yung good works na ginagawa natin kasi na-enlightened na tayo. And when they see good works in us, they will glorify the Father in heaven. It means to say, the glory doesn't belong to us. Glory belongs to God. Belongs to God. Okay. See, now, I want you to see this. In 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 14. Kabisado natin to. 2 Corinthians 6:14. It says, be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Alam ko na yan eh. Kabisado ko na yan eh. For what fellowship hath righteousness with unrighteousness? Anong pagkapwedeng pagkasama ng makasalanan sa matuwid? And what communion hath light with darkness? You can never put together light and darkness. The presence of light is the absence of darkness. The absence of light is the presence of darkness. Ganun po tayo dati. We were darkened before. But if you will go along with this verse, Father John, verse 15, it says, and what concord hath Christ with Belial? Or what part hath he that believeth with an infidel? Imagine that. 16. And what agreement hath the temple of God with idols? Anong agreement na pwedeng gawin natin sa mga templo ng mga idols? For ye are the temple of the living God. Kasi kayo ngayon, sabi niya, you are now the temple. And God hath said, I will dwell in them. What does it mean? Christ is with us, the hope of glory. And walk in them, and I will be their God. Wherever you go, God is with you. Whether we like it or not. Whether we believe it or not. But, and they shall be my people. 17. Look at 17. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. See? Wherefore, come out from among them. Because, why, you know why? Come out from among them. There will be no fellowship between believers and unbelievers, between righteous and unrighteous. There is no fellowship. Believe it or not. We should know that. Yeah, minsan nakakala mo, napaka-kuri mo lamang. Hindi ho. That is what the Bible says. That is what God says. That what we need to do. Nagtatrabaho ko, hindi ko yun. Di ba yung usapan yun? Ang ibig sabihin po rito, yung kayo po ay nakikipag-agree dun sa mga ginagawa ng mga taong walang pagkakilala sa Panginoon. When we work, we work. We do it for the Lord. Nagtrabaho din naman ako. Ginagawa ko yung para sa Panginoon. And I did my best. But my best wasn't good enough. Okay. See? See the difference now? Look at this. If you are truly born again, you are translated. You are translated from the kingdom power and dominion and power or power of darkness. Not translated na tayo, translated na tayo from death, sin, and condemnation, and move into the kingdom of Christ. We are now in the kingdom of Christ. Alam niyo, I don't know how to explain it, but I want you to know something like this. Parang ganito po yan. Parang ngayon, ito yung ano, dito ako nakaupo. Kita nyo, dito ako nakaupo, di ba? But when I came to know the Lord, doon ako nakaupo. Kasi ito yung darkness, ito yung light. But when you came to know the light and you are still sitting on the darkness, what does it mean? You are still in darkness. Nagkakamali po tayo, yes. But never sit with the scornful. Never sit with the ungodly. That is what the Bible says. That is what the Bible says. It says here in Romans 5:1, huwag na po natin ito yun, alam naman po natin ito, we were reconciled with God. Because of Christ, between God and us, there was peace with God. Hindi na tayo ngayon kaaway ng Diyos. Tayo ngayon ay mga kaibigan na ng Diyos. Na dati tayong makasalanan, dati tayong ganito. We were like this before, but now we were the friend of God. Now we are the child of God. Now we are the servants of God. Amen. My question is this, mga kapatid. Do you remember a time when you got saved? Ano bang ibig sabihin? Ibig mo sabihin, pag hindi ko natatandaan, hindi ako sigurado. Hindi. Do you remember a time when you got saved? Ako po, kung kahit paulit-ulit nyo kung ipashare sa akin ang kaligtasan ko, I will share it to you. I got saved in a school while I'm studying. There is a pastor there. He's a Baptist pastor. His name is Manuel Serna. He came and shared the gospel. I repented of my sin. I accept the Lord Jesus Christ. Pero naging active ako sa church October 11, 1987. That's why I declared my spiritual birth October 11. But it be in between that day until October 11, there was a big change. Before, the Word of God is like nothing to me. But since that time, every time I hear the Word of God, it's like something, there is a light entering my life. Lagi ako na-enlighten. Pag narinig ko ang Word of God, I am being enlightened and I am being pulled by the power of the Word of God. Yun po naging unang change sa buhay ko. So there will be, is there a time that you came to know and you remember that you got saved? Are you excited when you are remembering this day that when Christ came into you and He said, let there be light? See now, yung buhay po natin bilang isang mananampalataya, that when the Lord comes into our life, we will never forget that. We will never forget that. There will be always an excitement in us. Okay. In 2 Corinthians 5:17, alam po natin to that we are a new creature now. But here, when we say we came to know the Lord Jesus Christ, is there a sense of having the Holy Spirit in you? Ang Holy Spirit, it will become between the Holy Spirit and you that will agree together. In Romans 8:16, look at this. It says in Romans 8:16, the Spirit here, the Holy Spirit, capital S, itself beareth witness with our spirit, small s, tayo yon, that we are the children of God. See that? The Holy Spirit Himself will bear witness in us. There will be a time that between you and God, there will be agreement. There will be a time that you will see, wow, because of the Holy Spirit, I can understand the Word of God. There will be a sense of understanding. There will be a sense of peace in your life because you know the Holy Spirit dwelleth in you. And here, look at this. When you see the Bible, is there a desire to read it? Although lahat po, minsan po, tinatamad tayo. That is not an excuse. But do we have the sense of desire, or that we have the desire that when we see the Bible, we want to read it? Isa po yun sa mga change sa buhay natin. We love the Word of God. Ito po, are you expecting a longing for the coming of Christ? Or let me say like this way, are you excited for the coming of the Lord? Are you excited? Amen. Praise God. Okay, in verse 5, Okay, in verse 5 says, ye are all the children of light and the children of day. We are not of the night nor of darkness. Okay, it says here, if you are in Christ, you are the child or the children of light. Amen. Alam po natin yan. But here, if you are going to look at it, being a child of God, does it matter how long you've been saved or whatever what position you have in the church? How matured you are, if you are in Christ, you are a child of God. What does it mean? Kapag ikaw talaga tumanggap sa Panginoon, hindi yun binibilang na, matagal na tong Kristiyano. Siligtas to. No. Deacon to eh. Ligtas to kasi deacon eh. Maraming ang pastor na hindi ligtas eh. Kung sasabihin mo, he's been attending church for 10, 20, 30, 40 years. Ligtas to. No. The thing that will save us because we have Christ in our life. That is the reason why we got saved. Okay, in verse 5, if you are going to look at that one in verse 5, ye are the children of light. Look at this one. Ye are the children of light and the children of day. Ano yung ibig sabihin nun? Light, you are the children of light and ye are the children of day. Two different things. These are two different things. Okay, in verse 5, talks of who we are. It says here that ye are the children of light. It talks about who we are before God. This is our nature. Ephesians 5:8. Says in 5:8 of Ephesians, for ye were sometimes darkness, but now are ye light in the Lord. Walk as children of God. We are the child. It talks about who we are. When it says, for you are the child of light, ang ibig sabihin po, tayo po ay ligtas, and this is our nature now. Notice this. The children, it says, and the children of day. What does it mean? This talks about our character and our deeds. Na ngayon po ay tayo bilang mga anak ng Diyos. Now, we are walking in light. Now, we were enlightened. The day means it talks about our deeds now. Meron bang pagkakaiba ngayon na ikaw ay anak na ng Diyos? Meron bang pagkakaiba? 2 Corinthians 5:17, we know that. Nothing, as a new creature, look at this, nothing will satisfy us in this world. You believe that? Kapag ikaw ay talagang anak ng Diyos, yes, we need money, yes, we need material things, yes, we need, ako, nagpipray nga kami ng kotse, ng sasakyan, para makapunta sa ng maayos sa trompyang tabi. It means to say, we need those things. But those things are not the one give us joy. The things that will give us joy, it is because we have the light in our life. It is because Christ is in us. And in this world, nothing will satisfy us. If this world satisfies you, there is a problem in you. Colossians chapter 3, verse 1 and 2 and 3 ba yun? Anong sabi doon? In Colossians chapter 3. Brother John, please. Colossians 3:1. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ seated on the right hand of God. This is our desire now. Ito mga bagay nito, materials lang to. We need to know that. Yes, we need money. Kapag lalo na pag wala kang pera, hindi mapinta ang mukha mo. Di ba? Pare-pareho tayo nakaka-experience nan. Huwag mo sabihin si Sid, kahit pag wala kang pera, Sid, siguradong si Sumangon, medyo mapapasimangon ka. Lalo naman po ako. May nagpapaaral pa man din kami. Di ba, Brother Riddell? Mahirap po magpaaral ng college. Lalo na kapag sabi niyang pa. Alam ko na yun. So we need money. Kapag ang ibig sabihin, but these things will not satisfy us. It will not satisfy our heart. Only Christ will satisfy our life. It says in Galatians chapter 5, verse 22, now we have the fruit of the Spirit because now we are the child of God. Now there is an evidence of we came to know the Lord Jesus Christ. Love, joy, peace. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith. 23, hanggang 23 ba yan? Meekness, temperance, against such there is no law. This is the evidence, okay? Ito po ngayon yung evidence na meron na tayong Kristo sa buhay, that we have those things in our life. In verse 6, look at verse 6. In verse 5, it talks about who we are. In verse 6, it says, And now ye know what... Mali pa. Lumilipad kasi, sorry. Asa ba yun? Okay, basahin ko na lang. Therefore, let us not sleep as do others, but let us watch and be sober. What does it mean in this? Live a different life. Kasi look at the word, as do others. Huwag tayong mamuhay kamukha ng sa kanila. Be separate from among them. Amen. Do not do what others do, but the Lord Word of God says, be different, because we are now the children of light. Okay? The work of darkness are not in us anymore. In verse 7, for they that sleep in the night, and they that be drunken are drunken in the night. Now you will see that, anong ibig sabihin po nito? In verse 7, the work of darkness. Immorality is being done mostly at night. Alam po natin yan. Natural, and the natural to the world, this is natural. Okay? To the world, natural po ito. Kapag nakita po natin ng mga unbelievers, they go in nightclub, they go drinking, they go smoking, they go cursing, they go in a place where God will not be glorified. Don't wonder. Huwag na kayong magtaka kung bakit nagagawa nila yun, kasi nga, unbeliever ho sila. They are not like us. But the problem is this, when you see someone doing that, magtaka ka na kung bakit ginagawa niya yun. Magtanong ka na, bakit ginagawa niya yun? Why is he doing the works of the world when he is not of the world? Amen? Pero sabi po rito, don't do as others do, because we are now enlightened. When unbelievers see, misan ganito po tayo, when we see things being done by the unbeliever, di ba? In Psalm 73, sabi niya, buti pa itong mga unbeliever na to, yung mayaman, the unbelievers are getting wealthy, they have a lot of treasure in their life. Then ang sabi niya ng Word of God, huwag kang maiingit. For their wealth will be for a moment. Anong verse ba yung nasabi ko? Sabi niya, the wealth of the right, although the wealth of the righteous is not many. Hindi po marami. Sabi niya, meron man tayong konti, pero hindi ito kamukha ng riches ng mga unbelievers na meron silang pagkarami-rami, but it's not the same. You know why? The difference between that is Christ. So when we see the unbelievers, when we see them doing things not glorifying to God, huwag na kayong magmamarvel. Huwag na kayong magtataka. No, but check, gawin ko kaya. Pag ginawa mo yun, iba ka. Ibang iba ka. Why? Because you are now a child of God. We don't do what the world do. In verse 8, ito po ang problema kasi sa atin. In verse 8. Verse 8, but let us who are of the day, enlightened, be sober, putting on the breastplate of faith and love, and for an helmet of the hope of salvation. Okay, the problem is this. If you are going to look at it first, you study the verse, examine it. In verse 8, it says here, who wrote the Thessalonian? Paul, right? If you are going to look at it in verse 8, Paul now is including himself dun sa matter na yon. And Paul says, let us who are of the day, tayo mga naliwanagan na, be sober. Ang problema po natin ito, we are not being watchful. We are not being watchful. Are you praying? Ano ba naman yan? Pray. Alam nyo, as much as possible, pray. If you cannot pray. Anyway, yan po ang kailangan natin. And that is the problem with us as a Christian. We are sleeping. But look at this, even Paul included himself. He said, kahit na ako isa ng apostol, I still need to be watchful and pray. It doesn't matter if you are a pastor. It doesn't matter you are the oldest Christian here. Be sober. Pray. How many times do we pray? 3 times. Alam nyo na yun. Okay, look at this. We may be serving God in 10, 20, 15 years in our life, but you know what? We can still fall in apathy. Alam niyo pong ibig sabihin ng apathy? Yung parang nagiging ano ka na, parang normal na, parang ano na yun, parang manihid ka na. You are not falling to sleeping. Falling sa yung, inaanto ka na, parang matutulog ka na sa yung pananampalataya, and you don't care anymore. That's why when the word of God is being preached, I don't care. Pasok dito, labas doon. If you are a child of God, that word of God that will enter here, it will fall in here. Yun po dapat. Tayo bilang mga mananampalataya. But the problem is that we are sleeping. Meron po mga, they are falling into apathy. Nagiging manhid na sila. Wala nang effect ang word of God sa kanila. Bakit? Because they are not being watchful. They are not sober. They are not looking on what they need to do in their life. Be on guard. There is no room for slumber. Wala na pong room. Okay. Tanungin mo, kayo ba mga preacher kayo? Dapat ba ganun ka? Kasi kayo, preacher kayo. Kami mga, hindi ho, lahat ho tayo. We have a personal relationship to God. Hindi ko dadalhin si Millie o ni Sed sa harapan ng Diyos si Millie. O ni Brother Ariel, Sister Wilma. O ang asawa ko, dadalhin ko sa harapan. No, I will bring myself to God and I will be accountable on every words, on every deeds that I did. Personal ho yun. That's what we are going to do in our life. That's why we need to be on guard. And if you will go back to verse 6, it says here, ito na naman dahil. Okay, it says in verse 6, therefore let us not sleep as do others. Huwag po natin silang gayahin sa buhay natin, kasi itong mga to, it is a normal thing for them to do these things. We are not the same with them. We are different from them. And you know this, matapos po natin pag-aralan, matapos po natin malaman that God will come and will get us, that there will be for us, we are now saved, we are now new creature, we are now have the benefits of the Word of God in our life, and we have now everything in our life as a believer. But listen to this, we may be now a new creature, but it does not eliminate the battle in our life. It does not eliminate. Hindi ko mo't ligtas ka na, wala nang battle. Actually, mas maraming battle po sa atin. We are battling on the works of the enemy. We are battling on this world. We are battling to read the Word of God. We are battling to pray. Kasi maayaw natin mag-pray. Ayaw natin magbasa. There is always a battle in us. So it doesn't mean we are now a new creature. Okay na tayo. No, we need to be sober because there is always battle in our life. Baliwalain mo to, and I will see and I will tell you what will happen to you tomorrow. You tell me. You ineglect mo ang bagay na to. Na sabi mo wala nang battle. No. Things will worst thing will happen in your life. So let us be alert. In Ephesians chapter 5 verse 15. Lapit na po akong magtapos. Konting-konti na lang po ito. Okay, 5:15. It says, see then that ye walk circumspectly. Anong ibig sabihin ng circumspectly? Carefully. Not as fools, but as wise. In 16. Okay, redeeming the time because the days are evil. Alam niyo na po yan. Kung gaano kasama ang mundo ngayon. 17. Wherefore, be ye not unwise. Okay, be ye not unwise. But understanding what the will of the Lord is. Understanding. How can we understand the Word of God? We were enlightened by the Word of God. We have the Holy Spirit who teaches us everything that we have read. Hindi niya ituturo sa'yo yung hindi mo binasa. Ituturo ng Word of God. Ituturo sa'yo ng Holy Spirit. He is the great teacher. He will teach you on the Word of God that you are meditating, on the Word you are reading. He will be a great teacher in us. So here, Let us walk circumspectly. Let us walk carefully. Ibig sabihin, mag-ingat tayo bilang mga mananampalataya. There will always a stumbling block before us. Hindi ho natin kakayanin yun kung wala ho si Kristo sa buhay natin. We should be walking in a holy life. Ito na naman tayo. Whether you like it or not, you should walk as a holy man and women of God. Kasi yun ang sabi ng Bible. Be ye holy, for I am holy. That is the word of God. So that when the Lord comes, He will not find us as He finds the unbeliever. Kung darating man ang Panginoon ngayon, hindi niya tayo dadatnan na ginagawa natin ang kamukha ng ginagawa ng mga unbeliever. Amen? Dumating man sa ngayon, we are so excited, nanghihina man tayo, it's okay. May sakit man tayo, it's okay. Pero pag dumating siya, how will He find you when He come back again? Ano bang makikita niya sa atin? Are we doing His will or we are so far from His will? Okay. Let me just close in this po. I hope and I pray that when the Lord comes, we have seen po kung alam po natin darating ang Panginoon, and we have seen who we are, we have seen what we need to do as a believer, and we need to be what we need to be for us to sabihin natin na to be to survive. We need to be sober, we need to be vigilant, we need to be alert. Let us do all those things under the power of the Lord Jesus Christ in our life. No one is strong. I cannot tell you malakas ako. No, I cannot tell you that. Ang sabi nga ng salita ng Diyos, like yung mga lilies of the valleys, they are here now, tomorrow they are gone. They are being burned. Pero tayo po, yung ginagawa po natin pagtitiwala sa Panginoon, if we trust in Him, if we do His will in our life, then God will be glorified. I hope and I pray ito po pinagbigay po sa atin ng encouragement. I hope that this one rebuked us. I hope this one strengthened us. So tayo